Prodigal Steve returns to Stardew Valley. How's it going, everybody? Last episode was the episode I talked ad nauseum about the 1.1 update, I think. This episode, we get the rice pudding recipe. Ooh, that's exciting. What else are we gonna do this episode? I don't know. I've spent some more time thinking about 1.1, but I still haven't come up with a decision. So until I do so, I think I'm just gonna put that to rest. Like, I'm not gonna talk about it extensively in videos, but I still do welcome and desire your feedback on that. So feel free to keep leaving your thoughts in the comments, even if I don't necessarily mention them, I am reading them. Let's get our chores done here. And it's Friday, which means brand new Iridium Sprinkler Day, which means brand new seeds. Which is actually great, because I did see we had some potatoes out there which require harvesting. So we'll go do that. I see some wine over there as well. Alright, that's 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 29, 30, 33. So it's 33, 67, 57 seeds with the new sprinkler. Uh, 68 with this kale here. Okay. Do we have anything else? We do. We have some strawberries down here. But those are not going to need to be replanted. So, what did I say? 68? You haven't encountered any crows. This is fine. Alright, what wine do we want? We've been making a ton of blueberry. I guess we might as well just keep on keeping on, huh? Again, I'm pretty sure those are the most expensive wine that we can make right now. Okay, get that stuff done. Put that back. We'll sell the wine. We have like... It'll be 8 days. After today. So we're basically just gonna be able to plant potatoes. So we might as well just make as many potato seeds as we can. So let's go talk to Krobus real quick. Snag a diamond. I'll go down the south route. I think we'll put this on the north end of our field. Ooh, we can actually chop this stuff for hay right now. We don't have rocks, but we're gonna need to get some because that gate is actually broken. Ooh. Get a scene with Penny. Steve, it's perfect timing that you showed up. I brought the children on a little field trip into the countryside. You know all about life in the country, right? I mean, I guess. So I was thinking, could you be my guest speaker for today? Yeah, sure, I'd love to. Great. Let me just call the children over. Jess, Vincent, may I have your attention, please? That was a statement, Penny. That was not a question. I have a very special guest here to talk to you today. Our very own local farmer, Steve. He has first-hand experience living in the countryside, so he knows all about the valley's natural resources. Yo, if you want to talk about the valley's natural resources, you should talk to Leah. A natural resource is a material source of wealth that occurs in a natural state and has economic value. That is a very, like, dictionary definition of that, and I love it. Oh boy, here we go. Is country life all about farming, or is it all about gathering from the wild? I think mostly we kind of gather from the wild, right? The valley is chock full of precious minerals, that's true. Let's go with seafood, though. We've been on kind of a fishing kick lately. Oh, Vincent's got a question. What's up, bud? Am I gonna marry Miss Penny? That's not an appropriate question. Behave yourself, or I'll have to take away all your star points for the day. Kids, man. It's probably enough for today. Okay. That does bring up an interesting question for the series, though. I don't know which potential spouse I'm going to marry. Eventually, we're going to get to that point. I can imagine it is a lot of work to take care of those kids. Alright. Honestly, like, in real life, absolutely not. And I say that, and immediately people are like, oh, he just doesn't get it. Like, typical... that, you know, you don't want kids. It's like, I mean, I've thought about it a lot. Like, I have friends with kids, and my friends' kids are great. But I just have zero interest in being a parent. But what are we going to say in-game here? We don't need to get too, like, deep real life. All these no answers are like... real bad. Let's just say that we haven't really thought about it. I am busy with other things. In game, also in real life. Alright. Ooh, we have a fishing spot there. Alright. I didn't expect that that scene to occur. But I'm glad that we went this way now. Alright, let's go see our boy Krobus. We shouldn't need to buy seeds from Pierre. We should be able to plant enough potatoes just out of our own stock. Which feels good. Hey, what's up, Kent? It does look like a decent day for fishing. Alright, Krobus, my guy. I got this for you. Where are we friend-wise with Krobus? Two hearts. We're getting there. All right. Yeah, give me that iridium sprinkler. I need it. We actually only need, like, five more now. I'm going to go up by Pierre's, though, and check, A, the calendar, because I forgot to check the one in our home, and B, I want to check the bulletin board. It's Shane's birthday tomorrow. Oh, we have to remember that. Jade Harvey. Yeah, sure. I think we have some jade. If we don't, I'm going to feel like a real jerk. Oh. So I'm drinking a lot of water here. That's like the third video that I've recorded today. I recorded like two episodes of Darkest Dungeon already. And they were... like an hour and 40 minutes together. So my voice is a little rough. It's not painful or anything, but I could tell, like, I was thinking about doing maybe even another video after this. And now I'm like, no, that's folly. This is a mistake I should not make. So instead I'll be finishing after this video for the day, and I'll go about doing some other things. Which is fine. I think we could just water these outright. Like, we don't need the seeds down, so I might as well. And then we'll make even more potato seeds, get them all in the ground. We'll make some fertilizer here. We need like 24 fertilizer. Which we have tons of sap, thankfully. Alright. Beautiful. Get this stuff done. I would like to do another video today, but I don't think I give my voice enough time in between recordings, unfortunately. But that's all right. I have all day tomorrow to record as well, and that'll actually put me like even further ahead than I would have otherwise been. All right, go ahead, drop that stuff off. Not that like any of you probably care too deeply about my recording schedule. As long as the videos go up on time, it's probably all you're really interested in. Alright, get as many of these potatoes in the ground as we can, and then we'll see exactly how many more we need. Although we're gonna turn probably all of these potatoes into seeds, just for next spring, if nothing else. Oh, we actually don't need any more, technically. Ooh, we have beans down there, though. I didn't see that. Okay. Snag these beans real quick. We've got strawberries. We have a ton of stuff to turn into seeds. Ooh, you know what? I'm actually going to, since everything is planted now, I'm going to run back to Pierre's real quick and sell that wine. Because that's definitely not something we need to hang on to right now. Okay. A little bit of a slow transition there, but that might just be my brain playing tricks on me. Oh, we need to check for that jade as well. Okay, that is going to be absolutely the next thing that we do. Wine. 3,600 gold. Beautiful. I mean, do we really need or want the kale? Oh, you can have that honey too. We might as well hang on to it. I'm gonna say hi to Abigail real quick. And Harvey as well. You live above the clinic. Okay, cool. Well, I'm gonna go find that jade, hopefully, for you. I think we have some in the chest. I imagine we do. But I definitely want to get that done before Harvey, like, completely disappears for the day. Apparently a rabbit or squirrel just disappeared into a tree and or bush. Well, or bush. Oh, man. Farm is really coming together. Oh, we have a ton of jade. I don't know why I was concerned. It's nice that we were actually able to use the seeds that we had on hand. That's huge. It feels really good. Like, we're getting to the point where we're almost self-sufficient. Like, we don't have to rely on Pierre anymore. Which, like, sucks for him. But, you know, it's super unfortunate, definitely, that... Excuse me? Harvey. You told me that we could hang out. You lied to me, man. What's up, Lewis? What's up, Haley? Haley's ignoring me. All right, well. It's her prerogative. It doesn't bother me. They are going well on the farm. Or rather, things are going well on the farm. Dude, where'd Harvey go, though? Maybe he's down by the river. He likes to stand down there sometimes. Alex, I haven't talked to you in like 100 years. All right, well, go do push-ups then, men. Don't let me stop you. There's Leah. I found everybody but Harvey. Okay, I will take that under advisement. We've already talked to Kent today. There goes Penny. Oh, we can actually talk to her. Okay. That's nice of you. All right, for real though, Harvey, my guy. You do not appear to be down by the river, as you are sometimes wont to be. We had him. Oh, what's up, Willie? I do put bait on my hook. Don't sass me, Willie. That's mean of me. Willy's just trying to be helpful. Okay. Let's grab this stuff, I guess. There's a ton of it over here. By this stuff, I mean coral, sea urchins, general sea detritus. I would greatly appreciate being able to find Harvey again, though. I don't know where else he hangs out. Like, I've only ever seen him down here, up by the fountain, over in that little patch, like, behind these houses, like, over in here. He kind of wanders around over there sometimes. But he's in none of these places. And I can't get into the clinic because he's only open until 3 p.m. So even if you were in his home right now, I would not be able to locate him. That's Pierre. I mean, I guess I could talk to Pierre. Might as well talk to Shane. Dude, you're already at the saloon. All right, those two are busy. Look, Every week you guys play this, and you don't get any better, Sam? I find this hard to believe. Oh, no Harvey, unfortunately. Is he just, like, hanging out up in his room by himself, then? I mean, that's what I'm doing right now, so I guess I can't, like, fault the guy. I'm actually just hanging out in my living room. But still, I would like to see him. I have the jade that he requested. I would like to fulfill my end of the bargain. Well, let's go lock our animals up and make some seeds, I guess. I suspect that this winter, which is a ways off, but this winter is going to be full of a lot of seed making. So I am going to be investing in more seed makers. We should have a ton of gold. I think the wood's going to be the biggest issue. Oh, let's actually make some stone fences, shall we? Repair that while I'm thinking about it. Oh, we also need to check our greenhouse. Man, I'm just slacking today. All out of sorts. Yeah, see, we've got a... got blueberries here that need to be harvested. Beautiful. Okay. Well, let's go down here and repair the fence real quick. Oh, I need to skirt the pond on the other side. Oh, this whole thing is done. That's all right. Easy enough to sort out. Beautiful. Okay. Let's just double check that none of the other fence is broken. No. All right. Close this up. Make sure everybody's inside. They are indeed. I'll sell this stuff to Pierre tomorrow. Because I still haven't verified whether or not selling items to him versus the shipping container makes us more money. We might as well put some potatoes in the thing before we head to bed. I'm gonna put most, and by most I mean like all of these crops in here. Because our inventory is quite full. Mushrooms can go in there. Blueberries can go down here. I really should put a pathway there. I've been talking about it forever. Maybe we'll do that tomorrow. This section could use a pathway as well. Oh, I forgot some kale. That's okay. We could do inventory management stuff in the morning. I need to grab a beer out of the fridge, though, before we go to bed, because it is Shane's birthday tomorrow, and he is absolutely getting a birthday gift ASAP. First thing in the morning, birthday beer. Forgot to say hi to the dog this morning as well. All right, let's go to sleep for the night. Got a lot to do tomorrow. I probably should have sold that stuff to Willy, like the seafood stuff, but like through the shipping container, but this is fine. Grab a beer, head out. Ooh, more magic crops. And more potatoes, okay. Oh, that's a lot of potatoes. That's like 32? Yeah, 8 times 4. Okay, well, I guess we'll be making more potato seeds today as well. Get those in the ground. Because we'll have, like, just enough time, I think. Because it'll be the 21st. Yeah, we'll have, like, literally just enough time. Alright, we have 22. So we might as well just stand here and wait. We only need 10 of them. Then we can plant our new crops, go find Harvey, go sell stuff to Pierre. That and that and that can go in there. Those can go in there. That can go in there. Basically, just want to move that up. Okay. Let's go plant these seeds. Got a lot of stuff to do today. Which is good. It's nice to be busy. It's a different kind of busy than we had been over the winter, so I'm still adjusting a little bit. Very confused about what my keyboard just did there. Okay, thank you. I'm trying to plant behind you. Okay. I figured it was probably planted, but I just had to be sure. All right, 820. Ooh, we can harvest these beans. If we absolutely need to, we can sell some of these crops that we have in here to make money. But I don't think we'll have to. Might as well make some more beans. Put those in there. Those. Okay. Let's head into town. Oh, we should have checked the traveling merchant yesterday. I'm an idiot. That's fine. I mean, ooh. We haven't done our animals this morning. Man, just completely out of it today. Got all wrapped up doing other stuff. Oh, there's more beans. Well, I'm glad I came down here now. Good morning, ladies. I'm sorry that I forgot about you briefly. I mean, technically, I guess you don't know that I forgot about you, but now that I've told you, you can shame me for it. All right, snag this. Oop, there we go. It's plenty of large milks. Ooh, fantastic. I should buy goats. But I don't know, we're coming up to the point where we're gonna need summer seeds. And those we can't just make via the seed maker just yet, so. All right, Shane is at work, so we'll have to find him a little bit later. First and foremost, go find Harvey. Secondly, sell things to Pierre. Thirdly, sell things to Willy. I don't know what we're gonna do immediately after that, but that's our flowchart for the day, at least the early day. I guess Pierre's, or Harvey, wow, is, yeah, he's up in his apartment. There you go. I did see the bulletin. Came here because I like the small town atmosphere and the potential for a holistic approach to patient care. I've grown to really love it. I'm glad. All right, 600 gold. I like it. Let's go sell things to Pierre. I hate that this door shuts behind me. I guess it doesn't technically lock. All right. There's Abigail. How's it going, Abigail? I mean, I didn't strictly come here to visit you, but I did make an extra effort to talk to you, so I guess it's a similar situation. Hey, you can have this daffodil, and also this duck mayonnaise, and also this other mayonnaise, and also this cheese. And I don't think I need anything else from you, specifically. So I'm gonna leave. Thanks, Pierre. Oh, I'm actually, like, very sleepy right now. I ate and had caffeine and stuff before I started recording, but that was hours ago now. Just because I've taken... It was basically, like, 2 hours of recording for Darkest Dungeon. Because those videos, like, even though the one was, like, 59 minutes of recorded time, it ends up being more than that for me, just because I spend time developing the party and applying trinkets and deciding what I'm going to upgrade, if I'm going to upgrade anything, etc., etc. Like, doing all the prep work, basically, before I start recording. And sometimes that takes just a couple of minutes, because I know exactly what I'm going to do. Sometimes it takes substantially longer, because we're in a rough spot, and I'm like, I need to evaluate the risk-reward of the various situations. Willie? My guy. I expected you to be here so that I could sell you fish products. And you are not here for me to sell fish products to. So I guess just to the shipping container then. I mean, that's fine, I guess. We can go do that and make some seeds and keep an eye on the time so that when it's like 5 o'clock and Shane is off work, we can go give him his birthday beer. And then that'll basically be... Well, it won't quite be time to call the episode. Still have a little bit of time to do stuff. We can go talk to Pam real quick. She should be standing here. What's up, Pam? I mean, I could have grown parsnips, but I didn't. Just didn't bother. Felt potatoes were more worthwhile. Okay. And honestly, I think we're probably going to be set on crops for the rest of the spring now. All right, let's go ahead and put that in there. We have so many potatoes. I want to try and clean up, like, the singletons. Like, basically make some space. If you catch what I'm saying here. There we go. Wait for these. There we go. Okay. Kale seeds. We only have 5 kale seeds. All right, that's fine. We definitely want strawberry seeds. Want a ton of those. Fortunately, this is going to be a little bit boring, sitting here doing this back and forth kind of thing, but that's all right. We can cover that up with some banter, right? The commentary. Which, unfortunately for all of you, I'm not especially good at. I think the commentary in this series is probably a little bit better than the commentary in Darkest Dungeon. And, like, I say that knowing the Darkest Dungeon series is substantially more popular. And at the risk of, you know, shooting myself in the foot, so to speak. Although I don't imagine that there's too terribly much overlap between the two audiences. I suspect that you're either watching the Darkest Dungeon or the Stardew Valley. And mostly by that, I mean you're probably just watching the Darkest Dungeon. But, and I think I've talked about this. The commentary in this series can be a little more freeform because I don't have to think about it so much, like, or what I'm doing in-game, you know? I can kind of just relax and mostly turn my brain off and just sort of podcast it, almost. Whereas in Darkest Dungeon, like, I'm constantly having to plan my moves, etc., etc. We have, like, way more beans than we're gonna need, I think. That's alright. Yeah, 62. I swear I said in another video how many beans we were gonna keep. 35, probably? Well, we have like double that. But that's alright. We might as well hang on to them. Yeah, we have exactly double. So now we have 2 springs worth of beans. Okay, that's fine. Potatoes, we need all the potatoes we can get. No question about that. But yeah, Darkest Dungeon I have to think a lot more about. And again, like, and I'm sure I've talked about this, because this whole sentiment seems very familiar to me. The reason I'm more strict in my commentary in Darkest Dungeon is because I talk through my thought process for every move. That way, they can be evaluated. Like, my decisions can be evaluated both by myself, if I were to go back and watch the videos, and also by anybody watching them, so that I could get pointers. And we can learn together a little bit. Like, if somebody's watching the series and I make a decision and it's objectively bad, they're like, okay, well, now I know not to do that. And then I think we all maybe grow from that. Whereas in Stardew, I can go on a, you know, 15 or 20 minute, however long it was, rant about, and it wasn't really a rant, but just sort of brainstorming session where I think out loud about the 1.1 update, and I can get a little more inside baseball about, like, the channel and my Let's Plays, etc. I don't know, I think that's largely why I still enjoy this series, even though, like, it's bad for the channel. Like, I should be devoting more time to a series that's getting or is going to get more views. Like, I should probably replace this with a RimWorld series, because a lot of those Let's Plays are popular right now, but I don't want to chase what's popular. And I'm cognizant of what time it is. I recognize that Shane is at the bar, but I want to get these last bit of potatoes in as seeds before we go do that. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I should replace it with RimWorld, because RimWorld's popular right now, and I think probably has more staying power long-term than Stardew does, but that could be bias as well. I thought that this series, when I first started the channel, I had Stardew as Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Darkest Dungeon as Tuesday, Thursday, because I was convinced more people were going to be interested in watching Stardew than they would be in watching Darkest Dungeon. And I think that was mostly my bias, because Stardew was new and I was really excited for it. And it's not that I necessarily enjoy this game more than Darkest Dungeon, but I thought it would be more positively received than Darkest Dungeon. And this is proven to not be the case. Although, like, the reception for the Stardew series has been very positive, like, completely positive. But there's a far greater reception to the Darkest Dungeon series. So that's what I mean when I say that was more positively received. It's not that, like, anybody has been mean or spiteful or whatever about this series. It's just more people are watching Darkest Dungeon, absolutely. And I think this isn't necessarily stuff that I need to or should be talking about, probably. But it's on my mind. I think about it a lot. Like, I look at my analytics. Not that that's a major driving force of, oh geez, the decisions I make, but it does influence them. Like, my main purpose with this channel is it's a hobby. And The number one rule that I have beyond do it until I don't enjoy it anymore is don't miss an update. That's like the most important thing to me, is that I don't miss any updates. And so far I haven't. I've changed the schedule and added extra updates, but I've never missed one. And I take a lot of pride in that, honestly. Even though this is just sort of like a hobby thing for me, I still like, I feel good about the fact that I've set a schedule that's realistic, and I've been able to maintain that. Let's go ahead and grab our artisan goods over here, just to make sure we don't have any others. Oh, we do. I didn't see any on this path. Ooh. But I'm glad I went down here. Let's come down this way just to double check. It's getting pretty dense over here, which is exciting. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just kind of like, stream of consciousness now, honestly. Just thinking about the channel. I don't know why I came down to this chest. This is not the correct chest for these items. Ooh, we can make... Oh, we definitely don't have the wood to make. We would need 70 wood. There's no way. If we have 70 wood, we'll make another bee house and another keg, but I don't think we do, even if it puts us in bed a little bit late. We don't. We can't make either of them, honestly. Which is not that surprising. All right, well... That's gonna do it for this episode, and I did kind of like just trail off there on my thought train, but regardless, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button. As always, feedback is welcome in the comments below, and if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time.